After studying this module, you shall be able to understand the crucial role of DNA in the development and functioning of living organisms, the structure of DNA as explained by Watson and Crick, three different models proposed for DNA polymerization, namely conservative, semi-conservative and dispersive models, Michelson-Stahl experiment, the detailed process of DNA replication. Deoxyribonucleic acid, that is DNA, is an extremely long macromolecule that contains genetic instructions used in the development and functioning of all known living organisms. It carries information in a form of unique genetic code that can be passed from one generation to the next. Each DNA molecule is tightly wound and packed into thread-like structures called chromosomes, which are wrapped around specific protein complexes. In eukaryotes, chromosomes are located within the membrane-bound nucleus, while in prokaryotes, they are housed within the cellular cytoplasm. Structure of DNA. DNA molecule is a double helical structure that consists of two right-handed polypeptide chain coiled about the same axis. Each polypeptide chain is composed of smaller subunits called nucleotides that contain three components, primarily a phosphate molecule, a nitrogenous base, cytosine, guanine, adenine or thiamine, uracil, a 5-carbon sugar molecule, that is deoxyribose in case of DNA. Watson and Crick discovered that the double helix of a DNA molecule resembles a spiral staircase with two sugar phosphate backbones held together by hydrogen bonds between pairs of nitrogenous bases. As shown in figure, the bases link across two strands in as specific manner called as complementary base pairing. Adenine pairs with thiamine and cytosine pairs with a guanine. Figure structure of DNA molecule. DNA polymerization / replication. DNA replication is the most important biological process that occurs in all living organisms, by which a double-stranded DNA molecule is copied to produce two identical replicas. The enzyme used for DNA replication is known as DNA polymerase. This enzyme catalyzes the formation of polynucleotide chains through successive addition of nucleotides derived from deoxynucleoside triphosphate. It usually works in pair to create two identical DNA strands from a single original DNA molecule. For replication, a DNA polymerase requires the following components: 4 nucleotides as the triphosphate forms ATP, GTP, TTP and CTP, single stranded DNA as a template, free 3 dash end of an existing strand, a primer, an existing strand of nucleic acids. Models of DNA polymerization. Three models for DNA replication were proposed after discovery of double helix model of DNA by Watson and Crick, as shown in figure. The first model is conservative model. In this model, the parental molecule directs the synthesis of one daughter molecule containing both parental DNA strand and other daughter molecule having DNA strands of all newly synthesized material. Semi-conservative model. In this model, the two strands of parental molecule separate and each of those strands subsequently serve as a template for the synthesis of new DNA strand. After one round of replication, the result is two DNA double helixes, each comprising of one parental and one new strand. The third one is dispersive model. In this model, firstly, the parental double helix model is broken into double stranded DNA segments, which then recombine in a random fashion. Evidence for semi-conservative theory of DNA polymerization. Following the proposal and eventual approval of the Watson-Crick double helical model of DNA replication, several scientists in various parts of the country started working on a possible solution for the separation of two twisted DNA strands. By the late 1950s, three hypothetical models for DNA synthesis were suggested: the conservative model, the semi-conservative model, and the dispersive model. Amongst these three hotly debated models, the semi-conservative model was finally given acceptance in the year 1958 after a convincing evidence for it came through a breakthrough experiment designed and performed by Matthew Michelson and Franklin Stahl. The experiment was principally based on labeling parental DNA cells with different stable isotopes of nitrogen. The use of a heavier isotope of nitrogen, nitrogen 15, would allow them to distinguish the existing DNA strands from the newly synthesized ones. Use of density gradient centrifugation, separation of individual DNA molecules based on their density when a sample containing DNA components were placed into centrifuge cell and spun at high speed. Experimental procedure. Firstly, a culture of bacterial cells was allowed to grow for many generations in a media containing only nitrogen 15. When examined in an analytical centrifuge, the DNA isolated from these bacteria showed the presence of single heavy band, which meant that the entire DNA in the cells contained only nitrogen 15. Next, a portion of the bacterial cells containing nitrogen 15 in their DNA were shifted to a nitrogen 14 medium and were allowed to divide. DNA was extracted periodically and was compared to pure nitrogen 14 DNA and nitrogen 15 DNA. Results and interpretation. As evident from figures, the DNA isolated after one round of replication was found to have an intermediate density. This observation led to the exclusion of the conservative model of replication, because if the hypothesis of this model was true, it would result in equal amount of DNA of higher and lower densities. However, the results were consistent with the semi-conservative replication as well as dispersive model, as in either of these cases, the progeny DNA obtained would have an intermediate density. After two conservative rounds of replication, the daughter cells were found to consist of equal amount of DNA with two different densities, one that correspond to an intermediate density of DNA of cells that were allowed to divide for only one generation in nitrogen 14 medium, and the other that correspond to DNA from cells grown solely in nitrogen 14 medium. This result was inconsistent with the dispersive theory, as had the DNA replication process followed the prediction of this theory, the daughter cells would possess a density lower than the intermediate of the first generation cells, but higher than the cells cultured and grown only in the nitrogen 14 DNA medium. Detailed description of DNA polymerization process. The process of DNA replication includes the following step. The first one is initiation. DNA replication begins when an enzyme known as helicase unwinds the two strands of DNA molecule by breaking hydrogen bonds between each nucleotide. The initiation point where the short segment of DNA helix opened up is called as origin of replication, and the structure thus created is known as replication fork. Subsequently, SSB protein, that is single stranded DNA binding proteins, bind to these unwound single strands of DNA to prevent them from breakage and re-annealing. Elongation. Meanwhile, as the helicase separates the strand, RNA primase briefly attaches to each strand and builds an RNA primer, which acts as the starting point for DNA synthesis. After the primer is in place on a single unwound polynucleotide strand, DNA polymerase 3 starts generating a new complementary strand by adding the reciprocal sequence of the DNA. This process takes place in opposite direction because DNA polymerase can add nucleotides only in a 5' to 3' direction. This means that on the leading strand, the bases are being added towards the replication fork, while on the lagging strand, the DNA is replicated in opposite direction of fork movement. Hence, the lagging strand is synthesized discontinuously in a short segments, which are often termed as Okazaki fragments. After that, RNase enzyme removes the primer RNA fragments from both strands and DNA polymerase 1 fills the resulting gaps with the necessary nucleotides. This process creates a single nick on the leading strand and the several nicks on the lagging strand, which are eventually filled to produce two continuous double strands of DNA by the action of DNA ligase. Termination. The last step of DNA replication is the termination, which occurs as soon as DNA polymerase enzyme reaches to an end of strands where no more possible replication could occur. The last portion of lagging strand where the RNA primer is removed isn't replicated. This region containing a repeating non-coding sequence of bases is called as telomere. At the end of each replication, a part of the telomere is removed, leading to shorter strands after each cycle. Finally, enzymes like nucleases proofread the new double helix structures and remove mispaired bases caused during the DNA replication process. The excised bases thus create few gaps which are eventually filled by DNA polymerase 1. Summary: deoxyribonucleic acid, that is DNA, is a complex molecule that contains genetic instructions required for the development and functioning of all known living organisms. Each DNA molecule comprises of smaller subunits called nucleotides containing three components, namely a phosphate molecule, a nitrogenous base, and a 5-carbon sugar molecule, that is deoxyribose in case of DNA. The double helical structure of DNA was discovered by Watson and Crick in the year 1953, which is one of the most famous discoveries of all time. While proposing the double helical model of DNA, Watson and Crick also suggested a possible route for DNA replication. The process by which a double-stranded DNA makes a copy of itself to produce two identical replicas is termed as DNA replication. Since then, three different models of DNA replication have been proposed, namely conservative, semi-conservative, and dispersive. The semi-conservative theory of DNA replication was given acceptance in the year 1958 after an experimental proof for it was provided by the two young scientists, Michelson and Stahl. DNA replication process begins with the unwinding of the two strands of DNA molecule. Further, each strand acts as a template for the synthesis of two new complementary strands. This entire process is assisted by following enzyme, helicase for unwinding DNA strand, DNA polymerase 3 for generating complementary strand along the template, RNA polymerase for building RNA primer, DNA ligase for joining Okazaki fragments, and nucleases for removing the mispaired bases.